wait, what? You're seriously considering air sealing your attic? Well, you need to watch this video because it's not only going to help you do a better job, but it's probably going to eliminate a lot of the frustrations that you would have faced had you not watched. So you probably want to use the cans of foam, the ones you've seen at the hardware store with the nifty little straw. But I advise you, as an energy auditor who has spent hours not only doing the work myself, but observing the pros, you want to make one minor upgrade to really set yourself up for success. Now, air sealing, it does not have to be perfect, but if you're gonna take the time, you're gonna put the energy, the blood, the sweat, the tears, and actually get up into a place that most people don't wanna go, you might as well make sure that the work you do is effective. All right, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to assemble what I like to call a kit and how to use everything in the kit, including which foam gun I like to use, how to load the foam gun, the adjustment dial on the gun, how to seal different spots around your attic, and how to clean and maintain the foam gun so you can use it later. So the kit consists of course, the foam gun. That's the main thing you need, and I'm going to show you a little bit more about that in a moment. You need the correct type of foam can. It's got a screw on top. They're a little taller than the others you're going to see at the hardware store. You need foam gun cleaner. That's an absolute must. You're going to need gloves. You don't want to get the foam on your hands. It's a real pain when you do. And you're going to need a utility knife for cleaning, scraping, and keeping the foam gun working. I've been using the Great Stuff foam gun for about 2 years now. The guys, the pros that I work with in the field, in the attics, they wouldn't use it. They use something a little lighter, but for me, who just goes around spot checking, touching up areas, using the gun on, then off, it's been fantastic. You can easily order it on Amazon, so I will put a link in the description if you're interested. Loading and unloading, it's pretty easy. You don't need to twist it on too tight. And if you do maintain a clean tool, especially around the connection point, it's not going to be an issue to spin these bottles on and off as many times as you need to. The little black dial on the back end of the foam gun controls the flow of the foam to some degree. The trigger also has a lot to do with it. It's hard really to put into words exactly how to get a feel for it, but once you go around your attic or your basement, it won't take too many attempts to start to get a feel for things. Adjusting the bead size is crucial for different gaps. Smaller bead is perfect for narrow cracks, preventing over-application, while larger bead quickly fills wider gaps, ensuring a good seal. The flexibility that the dial gives you allows you to tackle various projects with just the one tool. Which brings me to actually using the foam gun. I like to dial it up about halfway. I found that with the trigger, it gives me precision, but also allows enough foam to come out so I can get things done fast. The pros that I'm in the field with, that do it every day, they seem to like to dial their guns all the way up to full throttle and like spray away. The best thing about it is that none of this has to be pretty. It just has to be effective. If you fill as many holes as you can, you really can't go wrong. As far as cleaning, maintaining, because I do use my gun sporadically, I think I've got a pretty good system in place. I remove the can when I'm done and grab the cleaner. A few sprays here and there, and then I open up the nozzle all the way, pull the trigger to get things cleaned out. I use the razor blade to clean any residual foam on the tip and use the knife to scrape the hole where the foam comes out so it doesn't get clogged. Store your tool in a safe, dry place for next time.
If you're ready to get started, check out the links in the description of the video and do not forget to subscribe to my channel for more information about home performance, insulation, energy audits, air sealing, how to make your home more comfortable. Thanks for watching.